do is work with natural processes. So we're either trying to mimic or imitate or make use of natural drainage processes to hold up the flow of water. And we do that by storing it, physically stopping the flow, or making further opportunities for infiltration so the water can soak away.
This is where the problems start. And in terms of catchment management and making a big difference, this is where we can, you know, start to address the problem. Who'd think there was a problem here? You know, it's a beautiful place, well managed, it's a nature reserve, but we can address the problem here. These sorts of places have the potential to help the places downstream.
So the whole idea is we can create structures which deflect the water out of the channel onto the woodland floor, and then that water soaks away. So we're just using the natural geology of the site, really. And this is what's really meant by working with natural processes.
Each one, delaying it by a minute or two, can add to half an hour. You can't just put a couple in and say, job done, we've solved flooding.
And if you look at where woody debris has been in water for 20 years, it creates a really nice section of habitat. And often you get build-up of silt and sediment behind it, so you get a step change in the system. The Stroud Rural Sustainable Drainage Project is really about achieving natural flood management, enhancing biodiversity and improving water quality, reduce flood risk without interfering in those land managers' economic activity. Working in harmony with current land management of the Stroud Valleys.
You know, it makes sense. It's our solution because it's a Stroud-based solution. We feel connected with the people 5 miles away, up in the valleys. There is a solution which can save everybody all the way down the line, and every little bit of work that's done increases our chances of defending the houses. If you work with the river, your quid's in, basically.